The Aspire Forum is a convergence of innovative pioneers in the industry of energy and technology.
It's great to see familiar faces, people who have been here last year, new faces. Welcome one and all. It's a year since we got this dialogue going almost. What's happened in the world? What's changed? First thing, the report just came out about 2015. It has been the warmest year since we started recording climate and temperature, since 1880, 136 years.
We can dialogue and discuss and hear about what the latest trends are and really think about what the vision ought to be for energy management, energy distribution, and energy generation in the future.
Everything we do requires energy, and the way we do it today is just not scaled to grow.
Energy is the ultimate scale problem. If you don't have scale, you don't have a solution. What you have is a hobby, but I wouldn't try to affect the climate as a hobby.
Business itself is going to have to fundamentally change, take actions to reduce carbon, to increase focus on environmental sustainability.
The world in 35 years from now is going to have 9.5 billion people, yeah, and have astronomical increases in food, energy, water, resource demands, emissions. And how do you think about that and actually say, that's a business opportunity?
Our mission really is to try to reduce Apple's carbon footprint to zero. Overall, you can see our facilities are growing worldwide, but our carbon footprint is actually quantitatively reducing.
There's the sort of the standard sustainable energy programs that are out there, but we're looking for unique and some disruptive ideas that help to create this microclimate environment.
We want to be able to set examples, innovate. We want new technologies to take over. We don't just want wind, we don't just want solar. We want things that are gonna transform the entire energy market. We currently have 47 operating projects in 14 countries with 13 different technologies. The power goes out every single day, sometimes two, three, four times. When it goes out, we have to start diesel generators that burn very, very dirty oil and may or may not come on. And as of about a month ago, we have fuel cells operating in India, Bangalore.
We cannot continue on the trend that we are and maintain our environment without doing something different.
We have 100 million square feet of real estate and a lot of branches and consumers we interface with. So the more we can get smart and utilize that and take it back to others on our team, it's a big benefit.
Being passionate and driving towards the impact of energy and what that means in our future.
We've had so much incredible progress in the last 30 years. We've seen growth of technology, we've seen growth of development, disruptive technologies.
As we try to change this industry, which is so large and the market size is so big, the impact it has on people's lives across the board is enormous. We as a country cannot move forward unless the dialogue happens, there's give and take, and we find an effective solution that takes us in a different way.